Hi guys, welcome back to another edition of Math in a Hoodie. We're gonna make you guys math warriors. I'm in my hoodie. We're gonna break down the math concept of mixed numbers into fractions, where we turn mixed numbers into a fraction. Okay, so let's get right to it. Let's review real quick that a mixed number is the combination of a whole number with a fraction. If we just had the whole number 3, that would just be a whole number. If we just had the fraction 1/4, that would just be a fraction. So those together, mixing them, is a mixed number, okay? Now, I wrote the steps down on how we proceed with this. First step is we're gonna multiply the denominator by the whole number, okay? So in this particular mixed number, the denominator is a 4, and we're gonna multiply it. My up, down, x, if you can see it. We're going to multiply the 4 by the 3. What does that give us, guys? What's 4 times 3? It's 12. Okay? Now it says number step 2 is to add the numerator to that answer. So our answer was 12. Now we need to add to the 1. What's 12 times 1? I mean, 12 plus 1, sorry. That's 13. Step 3 says put as new numerator. So 13 is going to be our new numerator. So we did that. We multiplied the denominator by the whole number, and then we added the numerator. 4 times 3 is 12, plus 1 is 13. Okay? Step 4, keep the same denominator. Our denominator was 4, so we're just gonna move that over, okay? And now we have 13/4. Number 6 is simplify. We can't simplify that any further, okay? This is obviously an improper fraction, but you could check your work, couldn't you? Because we could do reverse, where we turn an improper fraction into a mixed number, which would be dividing the numerator the denominator into the numerator. How many times could 4 go into 13? It can go 3 times, because 3 times 4 is 12. And then how many would be left over? Would be 1, and we keep the same denominator. 3 1/4, 3 1/4, we did it. Okay, so that's the first answer. Let's try a different problem. Okay, guys, here is our problem 2 in the video of turning a mixed number into a fraction. Now we already know that more than likely our answer is going to be an improper fraction, and that's okay. This is one of those things where there's a few steps to do in order to get the right answer, and if you don't follow the steps, your answer will be incorrect, okay? So it helps to do as many exercises as you can so that you get the steps memorized in your head. Okay, so here we have 5 3/5, okay? Step number 1, we're going to multiply the denominator by the whole number. 5 times 5 is 25, and we're going to add the 3. 25 plus 3 is 28. Good job. Okay, now we put that as our new numerator. Going down to step 4, we keep the same denominator, which is a 5. And we can't simplify, can we? Okay, so our answer here is 28/5. Okay, guys, let's do another one. Okay, guys, here is our third problem in turning our mixed number of 4 2/6 into a fraction. Okay, now I put this one up for a reason, because some of you may look at this and already know that you could simplify 2/6. Okay. I'm going to show you that you could simplify it before you go ahead and do the steps, or you could simplify it after and you'll get the same answer. Now, if you simplify it before, the steps might be easier because you're going to be dealing with smaller numbers. And obviously, when we're multiplying with smaller numbers, it's easier to get the right answer, isn't it? Smaller numbers are easier to multiply together. So it's up to you. We're going to go ahead and do it this way first and simplify at the end, and then we'll do it again simplifying first and then doing the steps and to show you that you could do either way and still be okay. All right, so to begin, we're gonna multiply our denominator of 6 times to the whole number of 4. 6 times 4 is 24. We're gonna add our answer of 24 to the numerator of 2. 6 times 4 plus 2. 6 times 4 is 24 plus 2 is 26. We're gonna put that as our new numerator, right? Okay, next step, we keep the same denominator. Let's move the 6 over, okay? Now these are both even numbers, so right away we know we could divide by 2. Let's try it, because we need to simplify, right? What's 26 divided by 2? 13, good job. And what's 6 divided by 2? It's 3. So our answer then is 13/3. Again, it's an improper answer, and that's fine. Okay, so let's go ahead and try it the other way, where we're gonna simplify before and see if we get our same answer. I'm gonna read our answer up here, 13/3. So we can see if we get the right same answer, okay? So we have 4 and 2, 6. Let's go ahead and simplify our fraction first. So we're gonna keep the whole number the same, right? We're not doing anything to our whole number value. It's still 4. But we can go ahead and simplify 2, 6. They're both even. So let's go ahead and multiply each by 2, okay? Let's put our new fraction that's simplified. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 6 divided by 2 is 3. Okay, so now we're starting not with this, but 4 1/3. Okay, let's go ahead and follow the steps now and see if we get the same answer. So we're going to multiply the denominator by the whole number and then add the numerator, right? 3 times 4 is 12 plus 1 is 13. Oh, guys, we are the same, aren't we? And we're going to keep the same denominator, 13/3 and 13/3. You cannot simplify them anymore. They're the same. So you could go ahead and do it either way. You could simplify at the beginning or the end. And we got the same answer. It just depends on if you want smaller numbers to work with or not. Okay? Okay, guys, we have one more and we're done. Let's take a look at it. Okay, guys, here is our last problem. Hopefully you're remembering the steps. If not, keep exercising these problems with the mixed numbers into fractions. Do as many exercises as you can so that the steps become second nature to you, okay? So now our last problem, we have 8 1/2. We're gonna turn it into a fraction, okay? We're just gonna follow the steps. 8 times 2 is 16, and we're gonna add the numerator. 16 plus 1 is 17, okay? Take the 2 over. Can we go ahead and simplify that any further? We can't. Okay, so that's our answer, 17 over 2. Okay, so again, follow the steps and you should always come out with the right answer. It's fine if it's an improper fraction. You can always check your work by doing the reverse and turning the improper fraction into the next number. To do that, we go ahead and divide the denominator into the numerator. 2 goes into 17. How many times, guys? It goes in 8. How many's left over? 16, and we have 17. There's 1 left over. We keep the same denominator, and boom, we have the same. Okay? So just a way to check your work if you want to. So I hope this video of turning mixed numbers into fractions helped you guys and give you a little refresher. I hope you guys keep doing these so you can become the math warriors that I know you are. Goodbye, you guys. Stay safe, and we'll see you next time on Math in a Hoodie.